going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of our Road to Glory series. Today's episode 16, and I just like to quickly say, recently I haven't been playing very good FIFA. I basically had a day where I just kept losing games, and I won one game. I believe it was out of eight, and I drew one and lost the others, and I was getting really annoyed because I don't know why. I've been playing the exact same as I have been, and apparently it's not working anymore. So we do go into our first game of the episode, and it is against a 4-1-2-1-2 second variation. Very, very strong German League team, and the only player there that I'd say is weak in terms of like their ability on FIFA is Huntelaar. And I was basically expecting this to be an easy game. And it doesn't take us too long to win the ball off of him and place a lovely through ball into the feet of Herrera, who does finish that at the near post with his left foot. Lovely finish, making it 1-0, 12 minutes into the game, and putting us in a comfortable position. And as you saw at the start of this video, we are only 2 points off of the title. We already do have promotion, but of course it would be great to get the title, and we have, I think it's like 4 matches to do it in, so it definitely is possible, unless I do have the unfortunate, basically the terrible FIFA ability I'm having at the moment. Now, he does then make it 1-1 after half time, and you did see by the half time stats that we were dominating the game, although it did feel like a very even game, and he was quite a boring player. But he did take forever to basically do everything, and as you saw by that free that corner there, he took forever to cross it in, but when he did, it worked. So I don't know what he was doing to rearrange it, but it worked, and he does manage to win the game 2-1. So we do lose our first game of the episode, and it's really annoying because I didn't want to lose any games at the moment, but I guess that's another loss for us. But still 2 points, 3 games, still possible. We do go into our second match with our Premier League team this time, and our Spanish League team, and we come up against a bronze team, a full bronze team, apart from his striker being Ricky Lambert and his goalkeeper being Areola. And I actually think that Areola, since he got his upgrade from his silver card, is an incredible goalkeeper in this game, for me anyway, when I do use him. And Ricky Lambert is just, I guess, terrible, so I wasn't really worried about this guy's team, apart from like the amount of goals we could score just because of his keeper. And you can see by the half time stats there, we were controlling the game, even in possession, but he had no shots at all, and obviously because of that, no shots on target. And it takes us quite a while to get our first game, and our first goal, sorry, and it's a lovely finish from Rodrigo there to make it 1-0. And I was kind of like happy that we scored, but at the same time I wasn't happy with the type of goal I scored, because it was kind of a goal that I didn't want to score to possibly win the game. And not too long after us getting the goal, we did get an attack. He does manage to take the ball off, play one through ball, dribbles a bit, his player does make an incredible run, Ricky Lambert I think that is, takes the shot and scores, all from a counter attack, 2 passes, and takes one shot, first shot of the game, first shot on target, and it goes in the back of the net, and it's an absolute screamer from Ricky Lambert. Ricky Lambert, of all people on this pitch, is the one scoring the incredible goal, and not too long later he gets in again with Lambert, takes the shot, and it goes in. Literally, both his shots of the game were both on target, and both went in. I guess some people could say he's just clinical, but I just say that's basically just either me playing badly or just FIFA being its usual AIDS-y self. And I wasn't happy with the fact that we ended up losing this game. We do get a free kick in the 90th minute here. Amazing save. And that's just to show you, like, that's basically the type of saves he'd been making all game, Areola has. And it was kind of a game that we were never going to win, to be honest. Even though we should have, because it was a bronze team. And I was really frustrated that we lost to that, because when I saw it, I was like, yes, great. 2 points in the bag here. Definitely, surely at least 1 point. But no, we get no points. And you see by the halftime, by the end game stats there, we destroyed him in chances being made. Possession, yes, he had 1% more. But that's, again, like I said before, fitness. Possession isn't really anything that I think is really like worth looking at in winning games and stuff. But unfortunately, we do lose our second game, and we do go into our third match of the episode. And the latency did drop to orange as I clicked through, but I thought let's just play it anyway, seeing as I'm at this stage. We do come up against a 4-4-2 Premier League team, very, very sweaty attack, and then he's just shoved Aubameyang in there for the pure pace, because chemistry basically seems to mean nothing, especially on players like Aubameyang. It doesn't really affect his stats. Now, it doesn't take us too long to basically, from kickoff, get through. He does defend it very well, puts one pass and then two passes together, sprints straight through my defence. I don't know how Sanya isn't getting in front of him there. And I don't know what my keeper was doing. I didn't call him out. Tim Howell just thought, you know what? Let's just have a little wonder towards the ball, and then not do anything when the ball comes flying at my face. So we do go 1-0 down after I think it's like 3 minutes. So if I get the times wrong, it's just the screen I'm watching is really blurry. It's like really small, so it's like quite blurry in the editing. Now, back to the gameplay, he does then get an attack later on, crosses it in and scores to make it 2-0. And this was just after us having an obscene amount of attacks in, like, basically in his half. The ball had been after he scored his first goal. I was quite annoyed at that, that he just managed to go down and cross it in once and score, even though I had been crossing it in a couple of times down his end and not scoring. But as you see by the half-time stats there, he is actually dominating us in chances, and by looking at those stats, it suggests a much different story than what it was when I was playing the game. Because when I was playing it, it felt like it was a game that I just didn't feel comfortable in. I felt like if I can even get a draw out of this game, it will be a miracle, because everything was like, the ball wasn't settling. My players weren't passing properly, shooting properly, weren't doing anything, weren't jumping when the ball came to them. But straight from kickoff, we do manage to intercept the ball and score, making it 2-1. And again, I did sweat that just because I wanted to get back in the game. And when the chance is there and I'm losing the game and I'm not in a great situation, I want to get the goals to win the game. Now, I'm thinking about slowing down the uploads of this episode to possibly one every other day, so that this episode, like I've said, I think in the previous episode or two episodes ago, that it doesn't like drain the series out. So I think I'll go to one episode every other day, just so it slows down the series, so it doesn't come out so often that it gets boring. And that also means I have more time to edit and also get a new series up and going, which I've come up with quite a few ideas of, and I let you guys know a couple of episodes ago that I'm thinking about bringing out a new one soon. And as you saw there, we did put a lovely through ball from Herrera to our player, who got a lovely finish in making it 2-2. He doesn't get a corner, whips it in, scores to the corner, making it 3-2. We do then get a shot with Fellaini in his box. He managed to block it, and there was a bit of exchanging between the ball until we did manage to break through. And after we did break through, we did manage to basically put quite a few nice tiki-taka passes together. Played a lovely through ball there to Colocango, who finishes it, who we did sub on at half time, just a bit of pace up front, because Lukaku wasn't really doing anything for me, so I've subbed him off and sub Conor Glenko on, as you saw. So we do actually manage to draw the game 3-3, which I was actually really happy with, because it now means we're only 1 point off of the title. And it also meant that I basically just felt much better instead of just losing another game. And I do then sell for Goody, because of the fact that he doesn't have 4-star skill moves. I kind of use skill moves a lot in my style of play. And the fact that Feghouli was missing those 4-star skill moves was really was really hindering the fact on the attack with this team. And the fact that like Rodrigo and Conor Pianca both have the 4-star skill moves, Figueroa only had 3. It was really really annoying. The fact that as soon as I got it to him, I couldn't really do anything in terms of the skill move wise. So I do swap him out for Carlos Vela. And we do go into a fourth game for this episode, because I really wanted to see if we could get to the title for this episode. And we do come up against an incredible team in Division 7. I don't know why he's in Division 7 with this team. He should be in a much higher division. But he does have Guerrero, Ozil, Yaya, De Gea. Incredible team. And I just thought, is this really going to be a game where we lose when we're 1 point off of the title? And I basically put my... I went into my try-hard mode and just sat there, complete silence, and focused on how I was playing. We put a lovely through ball there to Conor Pianca, who does take a shot, hits the crossbar. I was really hoping to score there. Luckily, we do then pick up the rebound, though, with Rodrigo and score. So I kind of felt like that goal was deserved, and the fact that we had been playing quite well up to that point, and you see by the half-time stats there, we are controlling the game. He hasn't had a shot yet, and I saw that, and I was like, I hope it isn't like last game where he got one shot, scored, second shot, scored. We do then get a free kick, really poor free kick for me, but I find free kicks at that angle are quite difficult, so I wasn't expecting too much. We do manage to win the ball for him from his attack, and then we do counter from it. Great side tackle there from DeMarcus, and a lovely pass out to Conor Pianca from Rodrigo. Conor Pianca runs into the box, gets pulled down. We do get a penalty, and it's chance to make it 2-0 and double our lead, and almost securing the at least 1 point for the title. And I believe Perez does step up for the free kick, smashes it home, making it 2-0. And a very deserved lead, to be honest. He wasn't the best player, but his formation as well was, like, personally, one of the worst formations on this on FIFA, especially this year. The fact that he's only got one striker, and then his wingers or wide midfielders are so far back, they're not even there to support in the attack. So it was quite a flat formation, and I don't think that really helped. And the fact that he didn't seem to be a great player, like basically went hand in hand together and didn't play too well for him. He does then make it 2-1, and surely it's a bit too late for him to get back into the game. A lovely through ball there and a lovely finish from his player, but we do then shortly on do a lovely 1-2 quick passing between Conor Pianca and Rodrigo, and then I just decided to dribble slowly because he wasn't attacking me, and I thought he's giving me the space. Did a drag back, ran through the space, lovely, lovely finish. Such a tidy finish from Rodrigo to make it 3-1. And my celebration, basically, you'll see, was the fact that I was just so happy that I managed to basically get into a point where I was going to win a game for once today. Because I've lost 2, drawn 1, and I was just hoping for the win. We do then get a corner in the 90th minute, a bit of skill from Conor Pianca, drag back, does run through, dribbles it past the defender. We get taken down, so we do get another penalty, and I do give it to, I believe, Rodrigo, just to get him his hat-trick, or try at least, just because he is on his hat-trick, and I wanted him to get it, just to, just because it's cool to have someone on a hat-trick, and we do pummel it home, making it 4-1, and again, like in previous episodes, we've beaten incredible teams and lost to terrible teams, as I've shown you in this episode, losing against the full bronze team and being destroyed by Ricky Lambert and Areola. So that does mean we do get 5,500 coins, putting us on, I think it's about 20,000 coins now. So I think we will enter the draft in the upcoming episodes, but for now, guys, this is going to be the end of the episode. I hope you did enjoy. I hope you are enjoying the series. If you are, smack that like button. Give a comment telling me how to improve. Subscribe if you haven't already. If you do want cheap MSP and PSN, go check them out in the link description. And see you guys later. Goodbye. There's a fire that I won't say. There's a fire, burn the fire brigade.